I've been listening to people around the conference already and hearing all sorts of complaints about it being too cold, and all I've got to say to that is buck up. We got on the buses yesterday morning to head up to the airport, and it was 8 degrees, and so it's balmy down here. All my band members are out in the sunshine enjoying the warm weather, so that's the way that goes. Folks, if you've decided to sit up in the balcony, you just have to clap longer and louder, by the way, so you're a little bit more distant than normal. We are excited to be here. This is a high honor for us. We appreciate this chance to make music for you today, and I thought I'd just give you a few words about each of the pieces while we're scrambling back there in the set changes. The first work, the Poncheale Sinfonia, is on the program for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's a great piece of music. We've performed it a few times over the past 4 or 5 seasons now, and we have this chance to go after an original work by a major Italian composer of the 19th century. It's an original work for band, and I've programmed it specifically for this concert because as I talked to colleagues all across the nation about this piece, very few recognized it by title, and I thought that we should change that. And so there you have it, the Poncheale Sinfonia. Dig in, you won't regret that one at all. We move forward now with a work that comes about because of the admonition that we've received from the CBDNA board for a number of years, and that is to have our colleagues from composition departments on our campuses come to the national conferences, the regional conferences, and to find out what the band world is all about. In Seattle 2011, Melvin Miles did just that. He brought along James Lee III. I had a chance to visit with him out in Seattle. This was in 2011. And found him to be a beautiful person and someone who had great interest in what was going on. And had a chance to get on his website, hear his music, read more about the fact that has major symphony orchestras making his music happen. He needed to write a piece for band, and so that's what this is all about. We have ancient words, current realities ahead of us here. It's based on scripture. It's his musical expression of that rather powerful scripture. And to me personally, this piece is basically sort of a wake-up call to all of us. Ancient words, current realities.